Here we are with one of our PIs, Charlie, who's an industrial design major here at Georgia Tech.
So here in the wood room, we have a great variety of tools at your disposal. We have a CNC router, a drill press, a bandsaw, a miter saw, a table saw, and a lot of other tools on the tool wall. Today we're going to walk you through using the bandsaw, the miter saw, the drill press, and the hand drill, just to give you a good idea of how to start cutting and fastening wood. In the wood room, you can use multiple different tools to do the same task, but the miter saw is good for cutting long planks of wood. To open up the miter saw, you pull out the safety pin in the back, then clamp your piece of wood securely down so that you can't move it. Then you press the safety switch on the side of the handle, then the main handle itself, and cut your piece. The bandsaw is used for cutting larger and wider pieces of wood than the miter saw. To get a piece of wood ready to be cut, raise or lower the guard depending on the thickness of the wood by loosening the white knob on the side of the machine, then turning the three-pronged wheel on the back. Once the guard is set, retighten the white knob, and then move to the power switch. Pull out the red safety stop, then flip the black switch down. Once the machine is running, carefully push your piece through the blade, keeping your fingers far away from the blade. When attaching two pieces of wood together, you usually want to drill a pilot hole to be sure that the wood doesn't split. This can be done on the drill press. First, you're going to need a drill bit. Choose one that's slightly smaller than the screws you'll be drilling into the wood. Once you have your bit, take it to the drill press and clamp it into the chuck. Once it's clamped into the chuck, turn on the press and use the three-pronged wheel on the side to lower the bit into your piece. When drilling your piece, use higher RPMs for softer woods and lower RPMs for harder woods, and periodically raise the bit out of the hole to allow dust to exit. Lastly, we're going to use a hand drill to join our two pieces of wood together. First, you're going to want to clamp your pre-drilled pieces of wood onto the table securely. Then, you're going to want to find a driver bit to clamp into the mandrel of the drill. Be sure that the driver bit corresponds to the screw you're going to be using. Then, place the screw in the pre-drilled hole, place the bit into the screw, let go of the screw, and drill in the hole slowly. Thanks for joining us to learn more about the wood room. Remember, when you're done with any project, to clean up after yourself. There are vacuums placed around the wood room for your convenience.
For any more information on these tools or any others in the wood room, ask one of our friendly PIs or go to the Invention Studio Wiki.